Hello, Taurus. Welcome to your weekly forecast. This is your reading for the week ahead, June 27th through July the 3rd, 2022. For all Taurus suns, moons, risings, Taurus is on the house cusp. If you have your sun in the second house or Venus in Taurus, you can watch this reading. Please do keep in mind these are general forecasts, so they may not resonate with you specifically. As I always say, for the most accurate reading with the most accurate outcome, please come get a personal private tarot reading from either me or your favorite tarot reader out there. For your reading this week, Taurus, we are using Disney Tim Burton's The Nightmare Before Christmas tarot deck and guidebook. The publisher here is Insight Editions. If you'd like more information, you can visit their website at www.insighteditions.com. And then for clarification today, we are using the Gilded Reverie Lenormand cards. This is the expanded edition. And I don't have publisher information here. There's a little QR code on the back if you want to take a screenshot of that. You might be able to get some more information. Oracle messages today, we are using the Threads of Fate Oracle deck, Shadow Edition. 55 cards and guidebook here. There's a little QR code on the back as well. And the author here is Blair Porter and Britt June. You can find them at www.threadsoffate.com or at the Threads of Fate. All right, so those are going to be your oracle messages from there. All right, so here are the Lenormand cards that I'm reading with as well. Threads of Fate over here. Okay. Let's see what's going on for you guys this week, Taurus. Personal readings, I do offer them. If you would like to book a personal private tarot reading with me, you can find my information below in the description box below this video, also up in the right-hand corner. Just click the eye in the sky, that will take you to my scheduling page, where you can book a reading at your convenience. Okay, the cards are being naughty. So Taurus, are you being naughty? Let's see. Give me six cards for Taurus this week ahead, please. What do they need to know? What are the most important messages and energies you want to share with the sign of Taurus? June 27th or July the 3rd, please. Show me what are the most important messages and energies for Taurus. Like, share, comment, and subscribe. If you are not subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button right now. Click all notifications so you'll always be notified whenever I do upload your weekly forecast. At the bottom of the deck, we do have the King of Presents. I feel like that's your energy, Taurus. Yeah, the Hierophant is reversed underneath there, which may or may not be you. Someone went back and forth, is going back and forth on a decision here to do something the traditional way or do something in an unorthodox manner. I feel like the King of Presents is here to say, you're going to do it the right way. Part of you does want to rebel and do something completely different here. But I feel like at the end of the day, you want to do the right thing. You're going to give something, you're going to be very generous to someone, you're going to be very faithful to someone, you're going to give someone the benefit of the doubt, Taurus. You are going to be a good friend here, even though there's a part of you, I feel like, or this could be someone else here that's a bad friend. I feel like you're going to give someone a present, or you're going to give someone a gift here, even though they may not deserve it, or even though it's going against what you feel like you should do. Those are some messages coming through here. Now, of course, reverse the roles if that doesn't resonate with you, but that's what I'm seeing in those cards. How you see yourself today, Taurus? We have the Six of Potions, Scorpio. So today you are having fond memories of the past here. You could be thinking of someone from your past. You are in a very generous, caring mood right now. You want to do some kind of nice gesture here. You could be spending time with your children, your loved ones. You could be beautifying your home here. I'm seeing you could be doing something with vases or flowers here. What is the theme for your week ahead? Ten of Potions, Pisces. The theme for your week ahead has to do with your family, your emotional security, or a happily ever after here. I feel like you are experiencing the most love and happiness that you can experience this week. Something is going to put you over the moon, meaning you couldn't be happier about something. Now, this could be a family situation here, maybe a reunion of some kind. Maybe you're going to be getting back together with someone from your past. I feel like this person is going to make you very happy, or you're going to be making them very happy. This could be your true love here. The King of Presents represents true love. True love and fulfillment. This is the person you're meant to be with here. Could be a past life relationship. In the past, you did learn a lesson regarding the Seven of Needles, Aquarius. Yeah, in the past, someone here was very cunning. Someone here was being very strategic. Someone here was doing something under the radar. They could have been lying, cheating, stealing, or just doing some sort of research here. Could have been dealing with an Aquarius, another fixed sign. You learned something regarding this energy. You learned a lesson regarding this energy. We may have to go in and clarify that. But something was done in an underhanded method here, or something was done in a way that was a little bit sneaky, is what I'm seeing. What is your challenge this week? The King of Candles. This is a fire sign energy coming through here in the challenge position, a Leo, an Aries, or a Sagittarius. In the upright position, if I had to guess, I would say you could be dealing with a Leo or an Aries this week. I am getting a masculine energy. Now, even if you're dealing with a female, they are still coming up in a masculine energy. Just like to point that out. We are gender is one of those things where it can go either way in the tarot deck here, meaning there is fluidity here. So what is the lesson you are learning now? Now, someone is very passionate here. But the lesson you're learning now is the Seven of Potions. Look at that, 7 and 7. 77, sandwiching this King of Candles here. Okay, so you're learning a lesson regarding something that is a fantasy or something that is part of your imagination. Someone here has been kind of like in their head here, imagining bright possibilities, thinking they have all these options here. And in the challenge position is this energy here full of passion, full of wanting to take action, fully someone that wants to take the lead here. So it's kind of like, is this person going to act on their passion, or are they going to stay in this fantasy? So someone is being taught a lesson here regarding fantasy and reality. Fantasy and reality. Here we have a fantasy. Here we have, this is about the past. So could it be that someone here is being challenged to make a fantasy into a reality? What is your gift? Ooh, the Lovers. Okay. So This is love coming in here. There is someone coming in here. This could be your twin flame here, your counterpart. A perfect match here. Yeah, I feel like you're meeting your other half this week. I feel like you're meeting someone that you have a very powerful connection with. It could be a Gemini. It could be a fire sign here, a Leo or an Aries. Yeah, this person loves you very much. I feel like this is a strong magnetic attraction. I feel like this is someone that they are just I feel like you can see yourself having the happily ever after with this person. Yes. So let's go in and clarify the King of Candles here in the challenge position. Who is this King of Candles in the challenge position here? Or who am I reading for? Taurus? Who is the King of Candles in the challenge position, please, Spirit? King of Candles. We have the Bear. This could be someone who is a boss, so a baby boss, so an Aries. This could also be someone who is a mother, very protective, a little bit overbearing here. Very protective of you or you of them, very possessive. Tell me more about the King of Candles here. Ooh, the snake, the serpent. Something here is very tempting, but there could be something here that is a little bit evil, or even someone here could be a snake. I'm hearing a snake in the grass. Okay, so maybe we need to keep an eye on this King of Candles. Give me one more card for the King of Candles. I feel like this is someone that can snap at any moment. They could be very spiteful. This is someone that's very protective, like they're very territorial. Ooh, the ring. Well, that indicates a commitment or a karmic cycle here. So this could be your partner here. This could also be like someone's mother. I'm getting like a mother-in-law. There's something going on with this commitment, though. The ring represents a commitment here. This could also be a dispute over an actual ring, like a wedding ring or some sort of family heirloom. We have all fire energy coming up here with the Ten of Clubs, the Queen of Clubs, and the Ace of Clubs. I definitely pick up a fire sign here, a Queen of Wands or a King of Wands energy. I pick up Sagittarius as well. Someone is very protective over this commitment. All right, they will stop at nothing to get it, is what I'm getting here. And to protect it as well. Like someone really wants to put a ring on it, like obsessively. What is the lover's card here as the gift you will receive, Taurus? Why is the lover's card here? Let me get one card on this one. We have the clouds. There seems to be some confusion here. Either this is a decision that is very hard to make, or something here is being obscured. Why is the lover's card here? We have the bouquet. Or the flowers here. Yeah, this is the gift here. It's almost like, has someone sent you something here in the mail and you're not sure who it's from? Why is this person sending me flowers? Or why is this, there could be some confusion over their intentions towards you. Oh, the moon is here. Well, this person has very deep feelings for you. I feel like they want to give you a token of their love. They don't want it to be too obvious, though. But this person is really in love with you, Taurus, or you're really in love with them. Underneath the deck, we have the coffin. Right, so this could be something that ended and now is picking up again, someone from your past coming back. All right, let's see. What is your advice or what is your guidance for Taurus, June 27th through July the 3rd? What is your advice for Taurus? We have Get Wild. So someone wants to get wild with you, or someone wants to see your wild side, is what I'm feeling. Yeah. Interesting message. All right, let's take a look at the book here, if I can find it really quickly, or not so quickly. Let's see if I can find it. I don't see it on this side. Ah, okay, here it is. It says, to connect with our wild nature is to bring ourselves into a state of balance. Having been raised in a culture that favors order, control, discipline, and obligatory respect for authority, many of us get a feeling of danger when we start to veer off the given path. This card is asking you to spend some time with the primal, intuitive aspect of yourself. What immediately comes to mind when you think of that part of you? If your wild self was a movement, what would it be? If it was a sound, what would be the sound? What would the sound be? If it was a song, what is that song? Spend some time asking yourself what it means to you to get wild, and then make time and space for that. There's a wolf here. So it says, the wolf teaches us how to reconnect to our instincts, intuition, and wild self. In many myths and folklore, wolves are a symbol for the villain, the aggressive stalker. While wolves don't typically attack humans, when we moved away from our roots of hunter-gatherer lifestyle to one of farming, agriculture and domesticity, wolves became an enemy capable of the effortless destruction. But what happened within humans when we made the switch from hunter-gatherer to passive cultivation? We lost a huge part of attaining what we desire, and is the ability to visualize it. Continue to use your imagination while showing up for what it is right in front of you, even if you can't see how they connect. Yeah, with the Seven of Potions here, it's about connecting. You still have this fantasy, this imagination that's running wild, and you're afraid to go there. There's a primal part of you that's calling you to come out and play, and you keep trying to push that under. And they're saying that that's a natural instinct. And in some ways, it's not wrong for you to go there. They're asking you to bring that part of that wild side of you back. So, and there could be someone else here that brings that side of you out. And that's not a bad thing. That's why this deck is called the Threads of Fate Shadow Edition, because we're looking at your shadow here. Okay. So shadow, once you acknowledge and bring forth the shadow, then you can integrate it into your whole anima or animus. So this is what I have for you, Taurus. Thank you so much for tuning in. This is your weekly forecast. I will see you guys back soon. Take care.